Hey, everybody. Hope you are doing well. Today, we're going to do some music by one of my favorite bands of all time. Honestly, this band is easily within my top 10, and I would personally put them within my top 5 favorite artists of all time. Warrne Haynes is a guitar hero for me. He is an absolute musical hero, not just guitar, musical hero. The man's one of the busiest musicians in music history. He's just constant. If he's working less than 300 days a year, I'll be shocked. He is that much out there, you know, creating, collaborating, composing, and touring. And it's just incredible. So I love Government Mule. Love him, love him, love him, love him, love him. Okay. This is going to be an interesting one, though. We're going to do a 2-for-1 with Government Mule. And how are we going to do a 2-for-1 with Government Mule? Well, about 10 years ago, they released an album called Shout. Now, the album was released as a double CD. There's 2 CDs in there. And there's 11 tracks on the album. And so the first disc had Government Mule performing the 11 songs. They did everything. There was the band, and they killed it. It was fantastic. A lot of great music on that album. The second disc, they brought in guest vocalists. They brought in people like Grace Potter and Steve Winwood and Dave Matthews and Elvis Costello and Miles Kennedy. And so they had 11 different vocalists come in and sing the same song that they have on the first disc. But the only thing that changes, other than maybe a couple of guitar fills or something like that, this might be a slight alteration to the music, but for the most part, the band is still exactly the same performance in the background. You're changing the vocalist's interpretation of the song. And on top of that, they didn't let the guest vocalist listen to Warrne Haynes' original take on the song. So they didn't give him a guide vocal. They just said, here are the lyrics, and, you know, verse, chorus, whatever. Here's the layout. Sing it any way you want to. Interpret it any way you want to. And so you end up with this interesting sort of cover version of a Government Mule song, but it's on the same album release as the original version. And I think that's incredibly cool because you get this different interpretation, this different artistic release within, you know, minutes of listening to the original version. It's not like a, you know, sort of traditional, hey, let's cover this song, it'll be really good. Like, you know, when Van Halen covered You Really Got Me, or Jimi Hendrix covered All Along the Watchtower, or you know, I mean, obviously any number of other situations that we could list here. There was no time lapse between the two releases. They were in the same box. And it just creates, a really interesting juxtaposition between two different vocalists singing the same song with the same exact music in the background. I think it's incredibly cool. And there are some real stellar highlights on the cover versions, too. Grace Potter's song is fantastic. I already did a video with the Dave Matthews song, Forsaken Savior, off of the same album. Elvis Costello's song that he does may be my favorite of them all. And Warrne Haynes doesn't even play lead guitar on it. It's played by Danny Lewis, the keyboard player in the band. So it's, like I said, it's just a fun. I'll probably do more from this album in a similar fashion as well later on. But let's check out the song When the World Gets Small off of the Shout double album. First by Steve Winwood on vocals, and then we'll do the original Warrne Haynes take in the second video, or the second song. Ready? Let's go.
Thank you. when the world gets small, feel like it's closing me. When I feel like I can't go on, no reason to aspire, just can't rise above, there's you, only you. Voices of a thousand years when the world gets small, traffic on the highway, even more in my head, made me love. Life is so much easier. Oh, my friend is still around. There was a big smile on my face. When the world gets small, when the world gets small, mm-hmm.
Steve Winwood is a musical treasure. Just is. I mean, you think about it. You've got Mitch Mitchell saying that Jimi Hendrix said that he would have given anything to play in a band with Steve Winwood. They played on one track together off of the Electric Ladyland album. And, you know, again, he was a teenager. He was a kid. And Hendrix just, again, Hendrix, Mitch Mitchell, the band, you know, they would have done anything to actually have played regularly with Steve Winwood in the band. That's saying something right there. Not to mention his work with Spencer Davis Group and Traffic and Blind Faith and his, obviously, his solo career. I mean, the man is just straight up a musical treasure, and his voice still sounds incredible. Hey, let's get to the original version with Warrne Haynes singing off of the same album, by the way.
Small.
I could listen to Warrne Haynes play guitar all day long. And there have definitely been days where I have listened to Warrne Haynes play guitar all day long. As I said at the beginning of the video, it's an interesting juxtaposition between the two different vocalists and the two different vocal styles. They have a different interpretation of the song, although it's not as dissimilar as you might have thought, but there is a definitely unique characteristic to each vocalist's phrasings and just stylistically. Anyway, I just thought it would be an interesting comparison to do it directly one back-to-back. Anyway, with that said, I'm going to leave that there. Be curious to find out what your thoughts are. Please feel free to leave a comment in the comment section below. We can talk about it further. Know that I appreciate y'all, and I wish you all well. Take care.